Imagine you are hiking through the woods on a late summer's eve when you have the misfortune of coming across a rather disgruntled grizzly bear. Given the scarcity of food in these parts, he is delighted to have come across such a palatable entree. A series of transient depolarizations in your neural circuitry identify the bear as a predator and quickly decide that running away is your best option. In order to elude your pursuer, you'll have to react quickly at both the synaptic and cellular level. To accomplish this, a number of signaling molecules are released to various targets throughout the body. When faced with this type of stressor, the brain sends a series of messages that lead to activation of neurons in the peripheral nervous system. This leads to release of a neurotransmitter called norepinephrine. But how does this chemical signal get translated to a cellular response that will allow you to escape? The effect of the chemical signal depends largely on the type of receptor to which it binds. Ionotropic receptors are located in the cell membrane and have a pore that allows ions to pass through. Once inside the cell, the ions can alter the local membrane potential and increase or decrease the likelihood of an action potential. A different class of receptors is the G-protein-coupled receptor, or GPCR, which are part of a group known as metabotropic receptors. As the name implies, these are paired with a G-protein, or guanine nucleotide-binding protein, which is composed of three functional units, an alpha subunit, and a beta-gamma dimer. Normally, the G-protein is bound with a guanosine diphosphate, GDP molecule, and is inactive. Unlike ionotropic receptors, the GPCRs have no pore. Rather, their efforts are mediated by activation or inhibition of other molecules. When a signaling molecule, for example a neurotransmitter, stimulates the GPCR, the receptor essentially changes its shape, allowing the G-protein to bind to its intracellular domain. The alpha subunit then exchanges its GDP for a guanosine triphosphate, GTP, creating an active state. This results in the G-protein subunits disassociating from the receptor, as well as each other. The alpha subunit then binds to an effector protein, such as an enzyme, which then acts to increase or decrease the production of a second messenger. These so-called second messenger pathways can lead to a number of possible changes inside the cell. This is perhaps the main difference between ionotropic and metabotropic receptors. While the effects of the GPCR are typically slower than those of the ionotropic receptors, they are much longer lasting. An astounding number of second messenger pathways are found in our cells. One example is the cyclic AMP-dependent pathway, which, as in our example with our hungry bear, may be activated by the neurotransmitter norepinephrine. In this case, norepinephrine binds to a specific kind of GPCR called a beta-adrenergic receptor. Once this receptor is stimulated and the G-protein activated, the alpha subunit binds to an enzyme known as adenylyl cyclase. This in turn increases the production of cyclic AMP, which is the second messenger. Cyclic AMP will go on to activate protein kinase A, PKA, which in turn regulates a number of different proteins. Ultimately, activation of the cyclic AMP pathway may influence processes such as cell survival, the up or down regulation of gene transcription, and the production of several neurotransmitters and receptors. Now, back to the bear. At the moment that you first encountered it, your flight or fight instincts decided that it was in your best interest to run. The activation of diverse pathways in the brain ultimately results in a surge of norepinephrine, which binds to the beta-adrenergic receptor located in many of your organs. This causes your pupils to dilate, your heart rate goes up, and blood circulation is increased to your muscles to push them to their limits. It does this through activation of intracellular signaling pathways, such as the cyclic AMP pathway we have just seen. So, by binding to this specific GPCR, norepinephrine allows you to escape, despite the odds.